Next guest indicates the decline is part of a broader collapse in pandemic story stocks and meme stocks as a whole, going so far as to say the era of the story stock is over. Ranjan Roy joins us from Margins. Ranjan, what do you mean by that?
If we look at Peloton, in the last couple of weeks, the stock is down nearly 40% after their disastrous Q4 earnings. And Peloton represents better than anyone else what a pandemic story stock is. It had cool branding. It was going to revolutionize our quarantine life with connected fitness. It had this amazing story, and it was a solid business. And it is a solid business. It's still trading around 6x sales. You know, they quadrupled their revenue over the last 2 years. In any other context, it would be a great business. But because it got caught up in all of the story stock hype, you have a stock that dropped 75% and now appears like it's in turmoil. And I think the thing we have to look at is every single one of these story stocks, meme stocks, hedge fund hotels, the drops in the valuations, what kind of companies are we actually left with?
What do you make of what they did with the period, the window they had when their stock was a much stronger currency? And do CEOs have a responsibility, I'm thinking of Musk off the top of my head, to say, you know what, I think the valuation is too rich at this point?
That's the most important question, because Peloton, when your valuation goes from $6 billion to $50 billion, you got to sell more bikes. They invested $425 million into a new factory in Ohio. They bought exercise equipment maker Precor for $400 million. They tripled their inventory. They delivered on more bikes and getting them there, but there's not the demand. Their growth is decelerating. And their CFO in the last earnings call said 2022 is going to be hard to forecast. Of course it's going to be hard to forecast. Even next week, I'm going to Boston to see my family. It's hard to forecast right now. But you get locked into that valuation. You have to get to $50 billion. That doesn't mean you have to triple your inventory and try to meet that. You could still try to be agile, flexible, and tell the market, you are an extrinsic value on my business, and we're going to stay the course and stick with our strategy.